Not like there's a good time to be diagnosed with myeloma, but if there were, I would say that I was diagnosed at a very, you know, prodigious time, because I was diagnosed 3 years ago, and I feel like the entire landscape changed.
Yeah, I think there are so many new questions that are on the table with this disease. I almost feel like myeloma has been reborn as a disease. One thing I've thought about a lot is really, if you have a disease where the literature is very negative and says all these negative things, and you're diagnosed with this disease and you read that, how much damage that kind of causes. To some degree, the disease is a dangerous disease, but there are so many new things that can be done. And I actually think that's probably one of the most important clinical messages today in the clinic. When people come to me and say they've been diagnosed with high-risk disease,
right.
I kind of I freeze a little bit when I hear that, because to say to another person you have high risk, that's a very strong thing to do. That's nothing that I would lightly do to another human being. I feel I have to be very, very confident before I say those things.
As patients, I think, you know, a lot of the fear is around how can we live this long with a disease that is so stressful, that is so difficult, that impacts our lives so profoundly, and that impacts our careers often. If, in fact, patients are living longer, what would you tell patients about the future?
I think what we see is just the beginning of a revolution in terms of development of new medicines.
I, as a patient, feel very excited, and I know that there are positive things coming.